A warm greeting in the Holy Spirit to you, my dear friends. As we gather once again as a community, not separated, but together, even though the physical distance and even the timing might be different, we are still together to take a moment in the course of this week to allow a very, very brief and powerful psalm to inaugurate us or pick us up once again, that we might be able to be in God's presence. Welcome to this meditation time on Psalm 70. Let's begin, as we usually do, with some quiet. It's been a hot couple of days. You can hear the air conditioning going on in the background, and that's okay. We just let this moment to become still for each of us, still and quiet and very peaceful. So, let's take a position that's relaxed, peaceful. Nice deep breath. And we take some moments in the quiet to just listen to the silence. Lord God, we offer to you this time. May your Spirit enliven my heart and my words, as well as the ears and the hearts of all those listening and viewing and meditating and taking the movement of their life, such as it is, without evaluation, stopping for a moment so that we can drop down into this well of living water that was characteristic of the gospel this past Sunday, of the woman at the well. Lord, may your Holy Spirit bubble up from within us that we might appreciate this song, its sacred writer, its reminiscence of David, its history of a broken people, suffering people. May we encounter something of that same blessing for each of us. The fire starter for this psalm from the original version of the Bible Through the Seasons is entitled, Deliver Me, O God. This small psalm of five verses has strong similarity with the first beatitude in Matthew chapter 5, verse 1. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The New English Bible translates it this way. Blessed are those who know their need of God. To be poor in spirit means awareness of a total need for God. Absolute need becomes absolute blessing. The only other alternative to choosing God is despair. The Hebrew word Ebion in verse 5 carries the same concept of poor in spirit. A group of Jewish disciples of Jesus gave themselves the name the Ebionites. They found joy in their needy state, for they knew that the riches of the resurrected life would be theirs. When you have given up on everything and everyone as being the source of your happiness, then you are in a place where only the Lord alone can meet your deepest need of soul. This little psalm finds a similarity, almost an exact replica, in Psalm 40, verses 13 to 17, is really almost a verbatim similarity and coincidence. But somehow the verses of this psalm gathered together and uplifted, have a wholeness to them. Let's listen now in this message translation that we've been featuring in our Wednesday videos and meditations and on Sunday to see if we can capture the energy of the suffering of the psalmist, the sacred writer, and what he does with all the fears and exasperations that characterize his life. God, please hurry to my rescue. God, come quickly to my side. Those who are out to get me, let them fall all over themselves. Those who relish my downfall, send them down a blind. Let them fall over themselves. Those who relish my downfall, send them down a blind alley. Give them a taste of their own medicine, those gossips off clucking their tongues. Let those on the hunt for you sing and celebrate. Let all who love your saving way say over and over, God is mighty. I've lost it. I'm wasted. God, quickly, quickly, quick to my side, quick to my rescue. God, don't lose a minute. This psalm has been the introduction to what's called the Liturgy of the Hours in contemporary usage in Roman Catholic and other circles. God, come to my rescue. God, quickly come to my side. Lord, make haste to help me. What a wonderful way to begin. And this psalm begins with the need we have to find God at moments when it looks as though we just can't get anything else to help us but God. And so it drives us down, just as that sacred writer, to a place similar to what I was developing this past Sunday in the sermon titled Deep Well at High Noon. The sun at high noon shining on what you can't avoid, namely some suffering or some struggle that you're going through. But the deeper you go, you hit bottom and you find that you're not only bouncing forward, but you're coming up with gushing water of the Holy Spirit. This is a matter of faith. It's a matter of knowing that God, in this psalm, says he is the Almighty One, and he can have the power to transform your suffering into joy. Not a whoopee-whoopee kind of joy, but the joy of knowing that God is with you. Nothing can really subdue you or put you down, despite the efforts of those that might be trying to do that. For whatever reason, in their own life movement, you remain steady there and let the waters gush up from within. I revisited a book that I read many years ago called Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl. Viktor Frankl was an Austrian psychiatrist, imprisoned like his family, and all of his family died. He went to 4 different concentration camps in 3 years before the final liberation. And he is a master at teaching us how to observe what's going on. What helped him, I'm sure, through his own suffering, was his capacity to observe the same suffering for everybody and the different ways in which individuals would respond. Some would be heroes offering their life for someone else, like Maximilian Kolbe, who said, take me rather than shoot this other family, father with family. I don't have a family. Why don't you shoot me instead? Offers his life. Others wanted to commit suicide, and he noticed that in between being a hero or wanting to commit a suicide were all of these different experiences looking for meaning in life. And that's, he developed a thing called logotherapy, is that the essence of life is to find meaning in what you're going through. He gives one example that I've brought up at different times over the course of years as an example of this kind of shift, what happens when meaning is discovered. He was counseling a man whose wife died about 2 years before this current session that he was working on. And he was unable to move beyond the grief that he was experiencing. And finally, Viktor Frankl asked them a question. Let me ask you this. Which would you prefer? That you or your wife would be experiencing this suffering? He said, oh, I would never want her to experience this. He said to him, you saved her from it. And immediately, there came a surge of healing and a different outlook and almost a kind of joy as he found meaning in not having his wife suffer the way he was, but having him experience that. So that's what I want to pray in this psalm, that you would experience whatever you're going through, no matter what it is. Maybe it's not a lot of suffering. Maybe it's the simple joy of having the air conditioning on in your house while it's so very hot outside. You know, whatever you are experiencing in your life, allow yourself to get some kind of space from it so you can observe it and find out what is the meaning behind what you're experiencing at this time of your life. A well-known Zen teacher was interviewing a person who said, the person said, I've got such a terrible cold. And the teacher said, why do you have the cold? And the person said, well, I guess I was in a draft or I was outside and other people, I got a head cold. He said, no, that's not what I mean, the master said. Now that you have the cold, why do you have the cold? What meaning is there in it for you? We only discover that when we step back from what we're experiencing. Maybe do some journaling, maybe just some quiet breathing, just letting yourself be so that you can look at it rather than be caught up in it like the tail wagging the dog. When you can observe it, then you can allow these shifts of energy to take place. This psalm, all of the psalms, and all of scripture will help you to do that. You'll be helped to say, what is God's word doing as a vehicle to transport me through what I'm experiencing to some kind of enlightenment, joy, peace, benefit, whatever it might be? Let the Holy Spirit gently bring you to that place, through the sustaining you through the bubbling waters of the Holy Spirit, to bring you to a place where you can look at it, accept it, and find meaning and ultimately joy in all that you're experiencing. Once again, thank you for joining with us. It's always been my honor and pleasure to share these thoughts and reflections with you on scripture, and I pray that you have a peaceful rest of the week. Join us if you're able in person at our service in Mattawan, Aberdeen, actually, Mattawan United Methodist Church on Atlantic Avenue and Church Street in Aberdeen. Sunday at 9:45 with praise music and then our worship together. God bless you. May you find great peace, joy, and happiness. Mm-hmm.